speaking of your users who are also staying home, many of those users are children, including my children. And some of these kids are not just on YouTube kids, they're on YouTube proper. How much of a surge in the activity do you think is from children in particular?
So I also have three of them running around. They might pop in the camera any second here. So YouTube Kids, of course, is a big part of that. And I have, you know, young kids, and so that's, you know, the platform that they use and, you know, probably are using right now. But the area that we have seen a lot of growth is around content that is about homeschool and just schooling at home, learning at home, etc. I think, you know, the latest stat that I saw is something since the middle of March, videos that have homeschool or school at home in their titles has doubled. The consumption of those videos has doubled just in the last few weeks. You may have noticed that in our YouTube app itself, if you click on the Explore tab, there's a learning chip. And so a lot of the content that's behind that learning chip, you know, everything from Khan Academy to other education creators are on that sort of learning destination. It's an area that we'd actually been working on well before this crisis as a place where, you know, families can go and have young people actually consume a lot of that type of content. The usage of all that type of content, not surprisingly, has gone up quite a bit. You know, not just across the US, but really across the world.
Right. Now, the content that is for kids, that's great. Then, of course, there's the content that is not for kids that kids stumble upon. And just as a parent, here I am interviewing you. I'm not out there patrolling them. Have you made any product changes, I don't know, in the last several weeks, or has this, you know, sparked some ideas about how you can make the product even safer for kids, especially at this time?
Yeah, I mean, I think our primary area of focus there has been, especially when it comes to younger kids, in terms of what we're doing in the YouTube Kids app, of course, and the usage of that has grown as we continue to roll that out in more parts of the world. You know, the way that I think about it is the primary objective there is, you know, we're partnering with parents. And so are there controls that we can give to parents? And we've built a lot of those actually relatively recently. So where parents can, you know, for example, choose different levels of control that they want over both the time as well as the nature of the content that their kids are consuming. So a setting, for example, where you know, you can actually choose on a video by video basis if you want to have that level of control, or where you can just select trusted third parties, you know, who you know will have done a good job of curating the content that's more aligned with your values or the way that you'd like to set controls, or if you want to have, you know, kind of the YouTube algorithm do that on your behalf. And we've given those choices to parents. And so a lot of what, you know, you see, for example, in the Kids app and the way that we think about it in general is really around parental control. Parents set those boundaries at different levels, not just based on the age of their kids, but also just in terms of, you know, their own set of values, how they think about that. And of course, that varies dramatically all across the world. And so we think that that's the best way to you know, have parents exercise control over what their kids are consuming.